Resilience is the ability to absorb shocks and continue to function. It's a word that's gaining a lot of currency in recent years as more and more people realize there are some shocks headed our way. Financial shocks, energy shocks, environmental shocks, as well as social unrest and international conflict. During this century, society must make the transition from aiming for perpetual growth to flourishing within Earth's limits. Resilience hasn't been an important goal until recently. Instead, we've prized economic efficiency above nearly everything else. We've chased competitive advantage to the point where nearly all our stuff is made where labor and resources are cheapest, meaning that most goods are transported to faraway markets using petroleum. And it's all paid for by way of a financial system that's leveraged with speculative investment and debt. This is all profitable, at least for some people, but it's not resilient. It results in a brittle society where a single financial, energy, or environmental shock somewhere far away can seriously impact just about everyone. What would a more resilient society look like? Well, first off, it would be less prone to shocks in the first place. We could reduce exposure to financial shocks by allowing less speculation and by forgiving a great deal of existing debt. What if investments were undertaken for the tangible benefit of communities rather than the speculative profit of the few? Rather than the corporation, which is designed to grow at all cost, our basic social productive unit could be the cooperative, in which members decide what to make, how, and under what conditions for their own benefit and that of their customers. We could foster an ethic of sharing and cooperation rather than ruthless winner-take-all competition. We could reduce our exposure to environmental shocks simply by learning to live within Earth's resource limits. That would mean slashing resource and energy use while doing a much better job of reusing and recycling non-renewable materials. It would also mean gradually downsizing the human population. At the same time, we could make it a top priority to protect remaining wild ecosystems and species. We could lessen conflict within society by reducing economic inequality and by making governance more transparent, inclusive, and fair. And we could develop better ways to defuse and resolve conflict at every level of society, from the household to the global arena. Localizing production of essential goods would minimize risk of contagious economic crises caused by shortages and bottlenecks. We've tried to eliminate redundancy from our global economy, but redundancy is an essential factor in reestablishing a healthy balance between resilience on one hand and economic efficiency on the other. A more resilient world will be different from what we're used to, but that doesn't mean we have to give up the best of what we humans have achieved. It just means adopting different priorities: survival and long-term quality of life over short-term profit and peril. Given what's at stake, that sounds like a pretty good trade-off.